No, my haere mai ra, haere mai ki te kaupapa o te ao nei e, piki mai ra, kake mai ra, haere mai ra.
E ngā waka, e ngā mana, e ngā kārangaranga maha, o te kupu taurangi hauora o Aotearoa. Nau mai haramai, whakatau mai, ki e nei akoranga tokotoru, hei akoranga I whakapakari I te hauora o te iwi Māori, e mau iwi ana ki tēnei whenua o Aotearoa. Mā ngā tākuta hoki, kia tiruhie, e rātou ki o rātou nei mahi, hei whakapakari ake, hei whakapai ake, mō tohunga Māori. Nō reira, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou katoa.
Tēnā koutou. Welcome to these modules, which are an introduction to understanding bias in healthcare. Having biases related to particular groups or individuals can impact on their health. These modules encourage health professionals to examine their biases and how they affect the healthcare they provide and their interactions with consumers. We can show implicit or explicit biases. We might show bias because of ethnicity, age, gender, appearance, sexual orientation, disability, socioeconomic status, religious beliefs, or for many other reasons. Becoming conscious of these attitudes and biases is the first step towards change. This first module looks at what implicit bias is and how to identify and address it.
I had started reading some literature around how Māori were not treated the same as Pākehā. And I thought that surely wouldn't happen to me because I'm not a racist. So my treatment of people was going to be the same. So what I did was try to prove that by auditing myself. And I started looking at how I was prescribing a particular medication called statin medications to people who had ischemic heart disease. So everyone who has ischemic heart disease should be taking this medication called a statin to lower their cholesterol. And what I discovered was that I wasn't prescribing the same rates for Māori and non-Māori. As a matter of fact, for Māori I was prescribing lower rates of statins than I was for Pākehā. And it really made me think, why on earth was I doing this? What was happening? And it kind of gave me a bit of a fright. And I guess that was my epiphany into realizing that bias was operating inside myself. So I kind of, every time I saw a person who should be on a statin, I started asking myself the question, why didn't I prescribe a statin to them? And what I realized was that I was attributing characteristics or values to that particular person that weren't based in reality. And so I might see the person in front of me, and because they were Māori, I might assume that they weren't going to take their medication, so I wouldn't offer the medication to them. Or I might have thought that they wouldn't be consistent with taking the medication, so I wouldn't persist with trying to talk someone into taking the medication, even though I knew that it was the best thing to do. So that was my kind of like initial journey into understanding how implicit bias really operated in myself.
Kia ora, ko kariri kura te moana, ko whangatawa te rātou, ko ōkokohui a ko tāmata māhoi ngā maunga e toru, ko tinana te waka, ko tūmana te tangata, ko te rarawa te marae, ko te rarawa te iwi hoki, ko Inia Tomas, ahau he uri au no te tai tōherau. So my name's Inia Tomas. I'm a consultant here at Middlemore Hospital, where I've been working for the past 2 years in that capacity, but trained here over the past decade on and off. Well, I'm always scared of saying I'm aware of my own biases because by definition, you're not aware of your own unconscious biases. But I think the first step is to accept that you possibly could have some unconscious biases. And I've done that. For instance, growing up, I had an unconscious bias against Pākehā. Because I was raised in a large Māori family, I went to kōhanga, I went to a bilingual school, And then when I went to high school, I was in a class that had three Māori students out of 90 and the rest were Pākehā, for the most part. Despite the fact that I'm half Pākehā, I always considered Pākehā to be different to me, and had a vague feeling that I didn't fit in with them. Actually, an overt feeling that I didn't fit in with them, and I think that affected the way I interpreted my interactions with Pākehā. They were always not the enemy, but other, different to me, and I didn't feel comfortable. So I think then getting into med school and working with patients and realising that maybe I was a bit discriminatory against them helped me to improve my overall care, actually. I think it was always okay for Pākehā, my care, because I was raised in a and educated in a Western, you know, in Western medicine at a university in a Western country. But if I was able to have that sort of attitude towards Pākehā, to who are the dominant cultural group in New Zealand, then, you know, I thought, what sort of attitudes might I have to other ethnicities as well? I had a breakthrough with Muslim female patients, for instance, when I decided to recognise that bias I had, and rather than just walk straight in and say, I'm not going to see you, I'll get the next female available female doctor, actually sitting, talking with the patient and the family who were there and asking them, were they comfortable to see a male doctor? And on two notable occasions, they were entirely comfortable. So because I'd recognised my unconscious bias, and inquired with the patient and asked them what they preferred, things went differently, better.
The human mind has evolved to categorise other people instantaneously. We're really wired to form impressions of other people immediately. And the reason why we do that is because it serves a protective function. You need to be able to determine whether someone is warm and approachable or attractive or someone you can trust, or someone who's going to be dominant. So our brain has evolved to instantaneously associate people with stereotypes, and that needs to happen because of the huge amount of information that we're bombarded with. We suffer from cognitive overload, and what that means is we have to apply stereotypes in order to make sense of the social world. Unfortunately, however, we tend to just do that without really being conscious of it, and the implication is that we can act in a discriminatory way without really meaning to do that. There's lots of different ways to define implicit bias, but in this context, it's probably most easily understood as being some kind of distortion in perception that people have in relation to particular categories of people. And that perception can result in behaviours which have a discriminatory impact, and then the discrimination itself becomes a problem. We talk about implicit bias as being a type of bias that people aren't fully conscious of. So it's coming from a level of awareness that might not be conscious to individuals. I think it's useful, however, to understand the idea of what implicit associations are. Implicit associations are, it's a scientific term, for the relationship that people make between a thing, a person, an object, a situation, and a thought or feeling that they have in their mind. So that's actually physiologically in your brain. Our brain cells make associations between ideas and things. So they're called implicit associations, and that's the term that scientists, social psychologists, and cognitive psychologists tend to use in this area. In social psychology, we understand that people generally have a natural affinity with people that are like themselves, so people within, we say, their own in-group, and that in-group will change depending on situation, but usually it's related to ethnicity, it can be related to age or gender. So how do societal stereotypes impact on the way that we see other people? So for example, there's a lot of research that shows that stereotypes around the elderly affect the way that we perceive older people and what they're competent and able to do, as well as stereotypes around gender that impact upon how people perceive leadership as being perhaps a masculine quality and nurturing a female quality. So all of these stereotypes exist in society, and the idea of implicit bias is that we internalise these into our minds without really being consciously aware of them. That's really important for understanding discrimination. There has been research in New Zealand that has looked at the attitudes that medical students in New Zealand have towards Pākehā, European, and Māori clients. That was carried out at the University of Auckland. And what they found is that medical students actually have pro-European and pro-Pākehā biases. By and large, these are implicit. However, they also have implicit biases towards Māori, and those relate to the idea that Māori are less compliant. Now, if you are a doctor and you're a healthcare provider and you suspect that your client might not be as compliant if you give them instructions or you give them medication or you're very proactive with their healthcare, and you don't trust your client to actually engage in that fully or less compliant, that can have quite negative implications for the patient and their outcomes because it means they're not getting the proactive care that they require.
Most of my clients are Māori, and what I do in my consultations is I spend a lot of time trying to build that initial relationship with a person. You do have to be a little bit brave, and I think you have to also acknowledge that the feelings that you're feeling about feeling confronted or feeling a little bit vulnerable or feeling a little bit angry, they're probably normal feelings. You have to acknowledge that, but you have to move past it. No one's really going to criticise you if you start this journey. People are going to support you. You're going to have a lot of people around you that are going to encourage you on your journey. And I think what you'll find is that it's a really uplifting experience.
Strategies that show promise in countering implicit bias for individuals include contrasting negative stereotypes with specific counterexamples. Individuate. Take time to see the people as individuals rather than stereotypical members of their ethnic or social group. Try to see things from the perspective of the person who is being stereotyped. Make an effort to mix with members of other racial and ethnic groups. Expose yourself to media that aims to break down prejudice and discrimination. And treat people as individuals, but also as part of the family and whānau. Our model proposes that there are two systems of thinking. Bias brain is triggered by our implicit biases. The thinking is automatic, fast, judgmental, and unkind. When we are under pressure, we are more likely to be operating in biased brain. Mindful brain helps workers detach from their emotions, which is where the biases are stored. They can then make more considered, thoughtful, and balanced decisions. This is especially important for professionals working under pressure because research shows that this is when bias is most likely to drive decision making.
Now you've watched this module, we invite you to make this just the start of your learnings about bias in healthcare. To find out more, make sure you watch the other two modules in this series of three and see the Health Quality and Safety Commission's website. Kia ora tātou.